Hollow Knight is the indie game equivalent of a PS4 exclusive, loved by players and critics alike, with fan videos dropping years after it was released. Everyone has heard about it and praising it like it's a fucking revolution. And for the first time, I will say that this game deserves all the praise it has received. Hollow Knight is a great game. Very few games where I have enjoyed my time with it as much as Hollow Knight. I have over 150 hours in this game, and this game deserves every single second I spent on it. There is no other game that has a price to quality content ratio that is this absurdly high. I just wanted to make this above clear if I seem to be nitpicking in this review. I genuinely don't have any major complaints about this game. If you enjoy Metroidvanias, the only barrier I see to your enjoyment is the difficulty, which isn't something everyone can enjoy. It can get tedious if you are really struggling with certain sections. And I have seen people say that they got stuck on the very first boss. You can click on the timestamp in the description if you want to see me talk about the difficulty. The opening section of Hollow Knight is pretty short, with a tutorial that introduces you to the game quickly and in a beginner-friendly manner. Then you drop down to Dirtmouth, which is the main hub of the game. There is an NPC there who seems keen to not do anything, but tells you where you need to go, but shows little to no interest in your success or failure. This reminds me of the opening of another game. In my opinion, it is not the combat or difficulty that makes this game a Souls-like. It is the storytelling and atmosphere. The characters talk in riddles and nothing is explicitly told to you, and the bulk of the story you learn is through piecing clues from the environment. Even after that, the story you get is incomplete and you have to fill in the rest with your own imagination. One thing I will say is that the load tablets are kind of boring to read, and this is coming from someone who thoroughly enjoys reading item descriptions, character journals, and things of that nature. The load tablets are like an IGN review. It has big words spoken in a boring way and tells you absolutely nothing. The exploration in this game is really well done. The areas make sense from a thematic and lore standpoint, which in my opinion is an underrated trait. If an area looks cool but does not make sense in the broader world, it takes away from the experience of the game. In this game, however, each area makes sense, and so does the animals, actually bugs, within this area. I will just talk about the first area in this game, and that is the Forgotten Crossroads. And it is exactly that, it's a forgotten crossroad. It exists between two places, but after the fall of the kingdom, it has been forgotten. The Forgotten Crossroads leads to 5 unique areas, each with different enemies and environmental design, which are not accessible due to the absence of movement upgrades in the early game. From this, it might sound like the game has a linear progression path like other Metroidvanias, but partly through it, it opens up massively and you can explore any and all parts of the map. This sudden freedom makes us confusion, but exploring the areas one by one, I made it all the way through to the end, but I did not want it to end. I was sad when I found out I had explored all the areas. I wanted more. Games that leave me wanting more are the ones I enjoy the most, and this part of the game certainly did. The exploration also works wonderfully due to the elegant mix of art from Ari Gibson with the stellar sound design of Christopher Larkin. Nowhere is this clearer than my favorite area of this game, Deepness. Ask anyone who has played the game about this area. Wait for them to recover from their PTSD, and I am certain they vividly remember how memorable their first trek through this area was, and listen to this soundtrack. Thank you. It just feels like bugs wriggling around, and this made my skin crawl. I won't spoil all the things in this area, as it will ruin the surprises. But I will say this, it will be one of the most memorable experiences you will have. Each area similarly has a unique look and feel, unique enemy types, and often a new gameplay element like the mushrooms in the fungal waste. This game also has one of my favorite map systems in any game. The game first forces you to explore blindly any new area you get to for a while until you come across the cartographer or hear him humming. This guy gives you an incomplete map and you have to fill it by yourself. That means this map keeps you both the tension of exploring blindly and giving you a path to follow once you have already explored. I think it's about time I talk about the combat. The combat is the most polished part of this game. It's very movement based and face tanking hits will lead to certain defeats. Dodging is the key to combat. The amount of control you have over the knight, also known as the protagonist, is pretty unbelievable. You can control the height of your jumps, change direction while in a jump, dash at any point and refill the dash by downstriking an enemy. And I will say one thing, if you intend to play this game through to the end, learn to downstrike enemies. In early game it will seem hard, as it did for me, but in late game you will be really fucked if you do not know how to do that. The quality of the combat is enhanced by the effects animation and sound design. The animation is not over the top and not overflowing with effects, but it beautifully portrays the action of the knight and the enemies alike. I have put a video in the description that talks more in depth about the animation in Hollow Knight. You have one weapon in Hollow Knight and this is your main source of damage. And you also have the spells, they act as both as damage dealers and Metroidvania style upgrades to open up a bit of the world. The spells are very good long range attacks and are fun to use. Desolate Dive. But the variety in the combat lies in the charms. The charms are a unique feature of Hollow Knight. You start off with a specific number of charm notches and can increase them through the course of the game. These can add effects like longer range, quicker attacks, or more passive effects like gaining more soul per hit or dealing damage every time you are hit. There are also certain charms like the Wayward Compass, which points to your location on the map. The thing that makes charms so good is the fact that creatively adding charms can double their potentials. Their interactions also have many unique animations. Experiment and you will find a charm combination that you will like. Now people might say use this charm or that charm, but truly use whatever charm that works the best for you. The regular enemies of Hollow Knight aren't really that hard. In fact, after upgrading your nail a few times, it becomes almost too easy to take care of them. I mean, if you don't pay attention, yes, the enemies could definitely kill you, but this damage can mostly be healed in a short time. Now let's first talk about the healing. To heal in Hollow Knight, you have to stand in a specific place and then use the soul you gain from hitting enemies to earn back the health you have lost. Now I would say this, after replaying the game, combat against regular enemies almost felt boring. There are however harder enemies, they have more health and deal double damage, like this guy in the Forgotten Crossroads. Although mostly fun, there are many annoying parts as well. Especially if you have to wait a long time to look for openings to attack certain enemies. Another thing is that except in one area, the game doesn't really throw a bunch of enemies at once. But when it did, I enjoyed it. In fact, I think these moments are of fighting are when the combat shines best. Before I move on, I will talk about the visual and sound design of the enemies. They're really well done. The enemies in any single area make sense in the larger context, and they sound really well, like the sound of the aspid spitting or the mushrooms rolling. Boss fights are the pinnacle of combat in this game. All the bosses are similarly fair, but have extremely varied movesets, and figuring out how their attacks work is half the challenge itself. Each boss comes with a rich history and lore which enhance the fight considerably. It is clear much resource went into the bosses. They look amazing, have well-timed effects animation that make it fun to dodge and find openings. The attacks of the bosses are mostly mixture of all the attacks of the enemies in that area, and though it may vary, but overall the game does a very good job of teaching you about the attacks even before you reach the boss, and rarely feels unfair. The game also has an extremely well done difficulty curve. It pumps up the challenge over time, and so by the end you will think you have gotten good enough to challenge the sun. If there is one thing to complain, is that not all the boss music are as good as the environmental ones or the ambient ones. Now, the death mechanics of this game is like a very small indie game that I have played and no news media ever covers. If you die, you respawn in a bench. Why do you respawn in a bench? This is never mentioned. The unique thing about the death is the fact that you fight your dead body every time you reach it and have to gain back the geo, that is the currency you lost from it. Platforming is another part of Hollow Knight, and it has relatively easy platforming challenges, and the hard one there isn't much to say about it. If you have played platformers before, you won't find it difficult. If you haven't, it might take some time to get used to, but the segment isn't that long, and I can say that you might enjoy it as much as I did. Now, difficulty. This is what I was talking about at the beginning. This game comes with a steep learning curve. If you ever feel like this game feels too difficult, don't force yourself to play it. This game is not for everyone. This game takes heavy inspiration from Souls games, and I know for a fact that many people find things like no save, no checkpoint and corpse running frustrating, and even being sent back a lot of ways after each death. And that's because it goes against the playstyle. There is nothing wrong with that. And I am not saying this to be a dick. I have seen people say that they have trouble defeating the very first boss. And lastly, if you're confused, to go talk to this guy. And if you're having trouble finding shit, go look up a guide online. This game doesn't really hand out items freely. In conclusion, Hollow Knight is one of the best games I have ever played, and I hope more people get to experience this game and buy this game. We need more developers like Team Cherry, and did a fantastic job, and I will end this by saying, who the fuck added primal aspects to the game? 0 out of 10. Never played.